Hello guys! Today we are going to be doing another gear review, and this time it will be our one and only beloved tent, Quechua Quick Hiker Ultralight 2-person tent. It has been with us from the very start. We have this tent for over 2.5 years now, and during these years we spent probably 6 full months staying in it, doing lots of wild camping. So we've tested it quite a bit in a different weather conditions and on a different terrain, and developed different techniques with it for the best use.
So in this video we are going to talk about the general specs of it, go through the installation process, comfort, durability, its benefits and drawbacks. So if you've been looking for an in-depth review of this tent with a real and wild experience, here it is. First we are going to take a look at the general specs of this tent, like weight, size and materials is made of.
This tent is quite light and compact for its type. It weighs 1.95 kg or 2.2 ounces. Its folded dimensions are 40 cm or 15.7 inches long, 15 cm or 5.9 inches high and 15 cm or 5.9 inches wide. The bedroom length is 210 cm or 82.6 inches. Bedroom width is 130 cm or 51 inches at the shoulders, 110 cm or 43.3 inches at the head and 80 cm or 31.4 inches at the feet, so it's 60 cm or 23.6 inches per person. And finally, bedroom height is 95 cm or 37.4 inches. This tent is mainly made of 40D polyester for fly sheet and 75D polyester for ground sheet.
Now let's find out what's in the kit with this tent.
There is a compression bag with compression straps of 9.5 liters and a second simple bag is provided to store the tent. But we personally don't use this one because it's very hard to get into with the tent and requires extra time. We find that one compression bag is enough. Then there is a bag with 10 angled deck lightweight packs made of aluminium, quite light and resistant. And the central pole or hoop, also made of aluminium. On the website it is said that it's resistant to breakage and frost.
So now it's time to pitch it up and see how easy and quick it actually is.
And to be honest with you, our first time pitching this tent up was a complete fail. And we spent probably a good 40 minutes trying to figure that out.
Maybe part of that was because this tent was the first one we've ever owned and we didn't know where to start. But be aware that at first it may take time to get used to it for a quicker setting. So first laying it down on the ground with the head and leg part in place, and instead of installing the central pole right away as we did before, we use a different technique now, installing the first four pegs on the four sides of the tent to get it in place, and only then install the central pole. We found that this way pitching up can be done just by one person without any assistance holding the central pole. Otherwise, if you install the hoop first, it needs to be held by another person in order for it not to fall, so it's simply not time efficient. But sometimes it's important where we need to figure out where the slope of the ground goes, and installing the pole first can help with that for quicker readjustment and relocation of the tent. But if you're sure about the slope, first technique works best. So when we have the first four pegs installed, then it's time for the central pole. It is important to watch which end of the pole goes first. So the plastic end goes inside and the metal one stays out. Not sure why the manufacturers made it like that, because it's a little bit confusing at first. And also it's important to get the plastic end all the way till the end really tight in order for the metal end to get inside the mount. Now it's time to install the rest of the pegs, and how easy it will be depends a lot on the terrain. On the rocky and hard ground it takes a lot more effort than with the soft porous ground, for example. As you can see, we use another peg to help install it in place. We don't use any other gear like hammer for that, just on the harder terrains we use rocks sometimes to help. But these pegs are great for that because they are angled shaped and very convenient to use, very rigid and easy to insert. They never broke at us. And now we don't have the full kit of them simply because we lost several of them in a rush.
As you can see, we packed 8 of them, leaving the central pole on the sides unpacked. Because we found that it's unnecessary in normal weather conditions with little wind, it doesn't make a difference but saves a bit of time.
But if it is windy, it is a must to pitch all the pegs to prevent the tent from moving a lot from side to side. Also, it's important to adjust the tension appropriately on every peg, then it will stay in place even in the strongest of winds.
So right now it takes us around 5 minutes as a max to pitch it up. As you can see, we've gone quite far from the time when we just started.
Of course, wrapping it up is a much quicker process. We unpack all the pegs first, putting them in their bag. then remove the center pole, which is quite quick, folding the tent on itself, first widewise, and then attaching the center pole, rolling everything tight together. With another person it will be even quicker. The tent fits into a compression bag quite easily without any difficulties. The packs fit nicely as well.
Now let's take a look at its appearance and discuss all the features it has.
It is a quite simple two-person, two-wall tent. There is another quick hiker tent in the series for one person if you are interested. It is a light grey color and we personally believe it to be one of the best colors, especially for the stealth camping. It is so hard to see. Even during the day in the shadow it hides quite well, but in the dusk and at night it's almost invisible. And we ourselves, knowing where it is, we're sometimes losing it out of sight and several times even stepped on it without noticing. So without knowing the exact location of the tent, it is nearly impossible to spot.
But let's get back to the features of the tent.
It has four rigid poles attached to the tent that increase the useful volume in the tent. Two ventilation openings at the front and back to prevent the condensation. It has two doors on both sides, but we personally normally use only one. As you can see, the zippers on the doors are covered by the extra cloth to prevent the air passing through. When you open the door, you roll the door back and hook it with the two loop systems that are quite big and convenient. Then there is a 60 cm or 23.6 inches wide porch or storage space for backpackers where it would fit two 50-liter backpacks easily. It is quite spacious. On the inside entrance there is quite big mosquito nets on each side that are quite tight, we must say. And even when the front doors are open, the air doesn't enter too much inside. Especially when it's hot and sunny and you want some fresh air, they don't provide it that well. Also, these nets are nice to enjoy the view outside. This inside door opens with two zippers and the door is only hooked at one point, which is not that great. On the inside there is one side pocket to store some little things in. And there should be two hooks on both sides, but we took one away because our hair was constantly hooked on it. And we just left one for the headlight. We found it is not too practical for us and we would prefer to have one in the middle instead.
So that is all about the tent appearance. And for us, one of the only disadvantages of this tent, that it's not self-standing one. And thus it takes a bit longer to set up. Impossible to relocate it quickly because of the pack system, but also it can be quite challenging to set up on specific terrains like sand, for example.
So now we're in the search for a good quality, budget-friendly, self-standing tent. And if you know one, we would be grateful to you to leave all your suggestions down below. Next up is the comfort of the tent and our personal favorite features of it.
When you are laying inside the tent, in terms of width and length, we feel like it's more than enough space for two people. We like that it has quite a lot of space above the head and under the feet to put some extra clothes and stuff like our cameras, power bank, etc. It doesn't feel too small, neither narrow or short. In terms of height, it is not that good and we definitely would add some extra centimeters above our heads. Because it's simply not convenient to sit up and eat, for example. You have to constantly curve your back. This is one of the only things we don't like about it. The absolute best feature it has is its big storage department, where we not only store our backpacks and shoes, but also cook all the time. It provides a great protection from wind or bad weather when we cook, and it is quite spacious and fit everything we need. So we definitely can live without this department, and in the future tents we'll look exclusively for the ones that have it.
Now let's talk about ventilation and condensation of this tent.
As you've already seen, the air circulates through two main vents, at the front and at the feet of the tent. And also mosquito net sections serve as additional ventilation. In order for it to work correctly, the tent should be nicely set up quite tight with the help of the tension on the pegs. This will provide the good air circulation and limit the humidity inside.
We personally haven't experienced any major problems with ventilation or excessive humidity using the tent. In the moderate or chilly weather it works fine, and the inside room of the tent can even heat up by your breath and also when you're cooking something. But in the hot weather it was quite bad, very stuffy air inside and impossible to breathe. So in the direct sunlight it performs quite badly. But even in the shadow or at night it was still stuffy and preventing air movement. So it performs the best when it's a little bit of a fresh wind.
Condensation, when it appears, is mostly kept on the second wall of the tent. So it's not entering inside of the tent. but if it's really humid outside, it can be there too. And anyway, the wet tent early in the morning, especially in the forest, in the humid areas, is no surprise. Great that it dries up quickly.
When there is wind, you can definitely feel that by some air movement, but nothing too much. To prevent the cold air passing from underneath the tent, we sometimes layered up some hay or fir tree branches when it was available, and it helped to some extent to keep it better insulated. But using the good pads and mats is the most important, of course. At this point, we'd like to mention the durability and waterproofness of this tent. This tent is definitely suitable for wet and windy conditions. It can hold a lot of precipitation, and even in bad heavy rains for long hours it was fine and no single drop entered inside the tent. The underneath part of the tent can get a bit wet after 24 hours of rain and wet conditions, but even when there was an actual puddle underneath the tent, the floor was just wet, so it's holding the water pretty good. Due to the water column test in the laboratory, the flysheet holds 4000 mm of rain and the room ground sheet 5000 mm of rain.
Also, it is stated that it resists up to 70 km per hour or force 8 winds, and we believe that is true. We had some real strong winds in the mountains, in the open space, and had no problem with it whatsoever. Nothing broke it us and it held it just fine. As we already said, for a good wind resistance, it's important for the tent to be well mounted.
We probably spent 6 full months for now in this tent and got quite a bit of a test. And now we can say for sure that it has a great quality, rigid materials that can hold the most powerful winds and the strongest of rains. It didn't tear apart in any place and the zippers didn't fail, although it is better to open and close them slowly to prevent them from freezing and stopping.
Also, we would like to mention that materials are easy to clean. We just wipe it off with some clothes and it's good to go. But because it has the closed kind of bedroom space, sometimes it's hard to shake out the dust and dirt, and you need to sweep it off. But it can be done holding it upside down by two people. When the tent is wet, it dries up very quickly. Just put it on a direct sunlight, and in a few minutes it will be all dry.
So talking about price-quality ratio, this is quite a budget-friendly tent compared to its competitors. And we think it is a great value for the money. Taking into account the quality of materials, its spaciousness and quite a lightweight. It costs £110 or €150 on the official Decathlon website. Also, Decathlon gives the guarantee of 2 years for any spare parts or materials of the tent.
You can purchase the tent on official Decathlon website in your country, for example Decathlon UK, Decathlon Spain or Decathlon France. And this tent comes in light grey color only.
And that is all we wanted to share with you regarding this Quechua Quick Hiker Ultralight 2-person tent. Now it's up to you to decide whether it's suitable for you or not and how you like it. In our case, this tent served just fine, not being too heavy and not taking too much space in the backpack. Having a nice color and giving us enough space to store our things and inside of the tent. In the future, we'd love to try out some new tents, preferably self-standing ones, with more height in the upper part.
But for the rest, we are pretty happy with this tent, and after 2 years of use it didn't fail, and we are sure that it is able to survive many more adventures in the future. So let us know in the comments below what do you think of this tent, and what kind of tent you are using now and how you like it. As we said, we would love to explore different gear and maybe even find another tent suitable for us. And as always, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay notified about the new videos. And don't forget to visit our website walkingnatureworld.com for more detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. And of course, you can follow us on Instagram and Facebook as well.
Take care, guys, and keep in touch.
See you very soon. Bye-bye.